Hello and welcome to another Instructable by the scientist formerly known as Nigeli. Today I would like to show you my solution of a bonsai watering system. The system does not require a water connection, therefore it's ideal for indoor use. One unique feature is the drip irrigation system. It allows an easy regulation of the water flow. The drip irrigation system is made out of socket terminal strips that are taken apart. Fix the tubing with the screws. Cut some wire to the desired length and then wrap it around the terminal socket strip, and you're ready to place it into the soil. Then shorten the tubing to the desired length, and with the help of a screwdriver you can adjust the water flow. Another unique solution is the housing, which is made from cardboard. And the cardboard is covered with pre-glued etching strips. So if you're interested, please keep on watching. For this project, you need a peristaltic pump. In this case, it's a 6-volt pump and a timer, which in this case is a digital weekly programmable timer switch. 12-volt power adapter and a power socket connector. In addition, you need a DC to DC step-down converter because the peristaltic pump is operating at 6 volts. Now I recommend you to pause the video to have a close look at the wiring diagram and how to connect all the parts. After having made all the connections, it's time to adjust the voltage of the power supply. You can see that the reading is 12 volts in the beginning, but with the help of the screwdriver and the step-down converter, you will adjust it to 7 volts. After the last soldering steps, it's time to power the system up and check if the pump is running. Now we come to the housing. This is made with cardboard. Cut all the cardboard pieces to the required dimensions. Protect your working bench with some tape, because otherwise you have the glue of the hot glue gun everywhere. With the hot glue gun, combine all the pieces to form the housing. Press the power connector into the cardboard to make a strong imprint. Follow the imprint with the pencil. Cut out the space for the power connector with a knife. Then you start to finish the housing. Now we come to the step where we cover the housing with pre-glued etching strips. These strips are used to cover the raw edges of plywood. I used the largest product I can find on the market, which is around 4.5 centimeters. The adhesive is on one side and the heat has to be applied on the other side, by the help of a flat iron. Here you can see the process, how to apply the heat. Now continue with the iron until the housing is fully covered. Trim the edges with a knife. Sharp edges are removed by lightly sanding with 120 grit sandpaper. Now make four holes into the front to later on fix the peristaltic pump with the cable ties. Fix the power connector with the glue gun into the housing. Distilled water bottles are very useful as tank. A square from styrofoam is used as a platform for the peristaltic pump on the tank. Now we do assemble all the parts. Place the tank on the window board, together with the stand for the peristaltic pump. One end of the tubing is placed into the tank. The other end of the tubing is connected to the drip irrigation. Then connect the power supply and program the timer switch according to the requirements of your plant. And if you like that video, please like it and subscribe to my channel.